Now let's try the profiler and see which parts of the program are time-consuming. So let's start the profiler for the main class of the server. Let's also start the client. There can be only one profiling session at a time, so we'll have to profile server or client. Let's start the client without profiler. Okay, let's start some more clients. Then they can chat for a while. Now they've been chatting for a while. So let's have a look at the results. Main here, which took this amount of time to execute, that's our program code. Finalizer and reference handler, which took those amounts, that's the profiler itself, not very relevant. And these last two things, that's the thread pool, the built-in fork jump pool. So that's also part of our program, took this amount of time. So let's have a look. Let's start with main. Most of the time is here, so let's expand that node. Then what? This one. Not very surprising, select takes a lots of time, because that's where it's stuck, blocking, waiting for something to happen. It's the blocking method takes this time. Apart from that, receive takes some time, right? It's this one. Send also takes some time. Start handler. Okay, let's look inside those. Receive message. Okay, now we're starting to split the time a bit, as can be seen over here. Various methods, so we look inside here. This is usual result. Split in Java lang string is slow. Very convenient to use, but takes some time. 10.5 milliseconds in that method, which is actually the most time-consuming method of receive, which in turn is the most time-consuming method at all. And for sending, it's the write that takes time. That's also quite common. Not very surprising, perhaps, that sending over a socket takes some time. Okay, what about the thread pool? Here's the run method of the client handler, the constructor, the broadcast method. The constructor took some time. Again, the method split. If we dig deep down inside, the dominating part is spent in the split method in Java lang string. If we look at the split method, it's just 3.89 milliseconds out of the total of 76 milliseconds in the thread pool. But on the other hand, the bigger part then is spent while the thread pool is idle here, waiting for work. To conclude, of course, most time is spent waiting for work. Then the real time thief is the method split, and also the actual internal workings of the thread pool take some time. If we look, for example, here in the thread pool's internal handling, it's this method, park. Okay, I don't know about this, which is internal to the JVM implementation, but park surely seems to be a method that is running while there's nothing to do for the thread pool, and that makes sense. It should be idle for quite a lot of time. Okay, so no big problems inside the thread pool. So the program spends time waiting for work and splitting strings. Are there any alternatives to the split method in Java lang string if we want that extra performance? One thing is we could use the Java util string tokenizer. It's supposed to be a little bit faster, but in the documentation says that use of this class is discouraged and suggests to use Java lang split instead. Then there's a third party library called Guava from Google, which contains many Java utilities, including a split method that is faster.